I lie to you, team captains Frank Woodley and Chris Taylor join us now live. Sorry about the problem with the audio there. Guys, it's great to see you both.
It's actually, I'm actually much, much more palatable if you can't hear what I'm saying.
I was going to say, it's the first time I've ever really been able to tolerate Frank on television. For the rest of this interview, can we mute Frank Zoom and then I'm happily to do the rest of it?
Well, actually, I want to go to Frank first, because before we get to your fabulous new show, fellas, I want to talk about Frank returning to the stage with your comedy partner, Colin Lane, for Lane and Woodley. Yes. Are you excited? What can fans expect?
This year we're doing Lane and Woodley in Moby Dick, and we've done a week of it at the Adelaide Fringe, and look, it went okay. Well, unfortunately, only one joke got a laugh. But fortunately, they laughed for 50 minutes afterwards. It was so funny. So we might be able to pull it off. We're not cocky, but we're mildly confident.
That is fantastic. Chris, I have never been so excited for a show to come to 10. Would I Lie to You? Oh, it's so much fun. We absolutely love it. What do you think are the key signs that indicate people may be fibbing?
Oh, well, that's part of the game, of course. It's a game of bluff, and you need to have your best sort of detective radar about whether someone's telling the truth or not. I found it kind of depends on what profession the person's from. So if they're a politician, the tell is usually that they're opening their mouth. that's sort of a giveaway. But the hardest to pick, I don't know, Frank, with the actors, who, as you could imagine, were very good at pretending or bluffing. So people like Pia Miranda, Stephen Curry, Daniel McPherson, they brought all the tools of being a brilliant actor. So I was completely lost. Just when I thought I had them pinned down, they surprised me.
Yeah. Just when you think that they're going to be... you hear a story that you think is definitely a lie. Like, for example, I don't know if this is an actual one, but at one point Pia Miranda said, "I raise money for charity by walking around Australia on my lips." And we're like, well, that's surely not. And then the video footage comes out and it's true. Like, it just blows your mind. You can't, your whole kind of confidence that you can appreciate reality is, I'm shot. I've lost my mind.
And then you just want her to do the rest of the show on her lips. Like, it's implausible that she'd ever use her feet again.
Yeah. Well, listen, we've got the audio fixed. Let's have a look at how the game works. Watch this.
I once heckled a priest.
Was the priest doing stand-up at the time?
The priest was delivering a little speech in a wedding. It's actually not something I'm proud of, what the heckle was.
What was the heckle?
Wrap it up!
Hey, Frank, have you ever been caught out in a lie?
Oh, look, I think I have many, many times. I mean, my nose actually started out like as a normal, like a small nose. I've often thought about that, like with Pinocchio. That would have been really harsh for Pinocchio in his real life, like just those little moments where he's saying to his wife, you know, she's like, "Does my bum look big in this?" And he's just, "No, it looks great." And it's just, it must have given him a lot of grief. But I don't know about lying in... I don't know. Maybe, am I lying? Am I really Frank Woodley? This is a mask and I'll just...
You would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for those
under here
rascally kids. Hey, we want to put your lie detector skills to the test and we want to play a game to see if you can tell whether Tristan is telling the truth or a lie.
Okay.
You'll have two questions each that you can ask to help determine if he's lying or not.
Yes.
Here we go.
Are you ready? Here we go. Now, I once rocked a pair of tight leather pants while starring as Sandy in Grease the Musical.
Sandy?
Yeah.
I don't think we need any questions at all on this one. Clearly true.
whether it's true or false, Tristan, you are definitely the one that I want.
Gave me chills.
How old were you during this?
I suppose it probably would have been early teens. Yeah, mid-90s, maybe. Mid to late 90s.
I think that when you're in your early teens, your legs would have been about as lovely as Olivia Newton-John's were in that film. I can see that. Did you wear a blonde wig as well, or...?
Yes, I did, yeah. Yeah, a lovely blonde, curly, shoulder-length wig, I suppose. Shaved the chest. I was an early growth.
Here's my other question. I just want you to give me one brief melodious line from the song you have to sing?
You're the one I want.
You are the one I want. Honey.
Gee, there was a lot of help from Sarah there, wasn't there?
Tell me about it, still. Yeah.
I think that's red herring, though.
My final question, I guess, were the Studio 10 talent scouts present at the moment, and was that moment was what led you to the hosting job today?
Do you know what? I wouldn't rule that out, one. Mm. But I actually went in between then. I went to Vegas. I went to Hollywood. Oh. I went to the West End. I went to Broadway. So maybe... It definitely worked, whatever it was.
What are you thinking? Which way are you leaning, fellas?
True. Oh, I've got chills and they're multiplying. What was yours, Chris?
Look, it was all very plausible. I can see him dressing up as Sandy. Yep. He started to lose me when he was claiming to have a successful Vegas career. But I think I'm going to go true.
Okay, and to make it interesting, I'm going to go false.
All right, well, you know what? We've roped in Tristan's mum to reveal the answer. Oh. Watch this.
Hi, Frank and Chris. Yes, it's true. Tristan did perform as Sandy from Greece in his youth, and he's never forgiven me for encouraging him to do that.
There we go. I've compartmentalised it somewhere in the back of my brain. It continues to affect me as a grown adult.
Is that you there?
There he is.
Yeah.
Absolutely gorgeous. Something stirred in me just seeing you there.
I'm feeling like I should dress up as John Travolta. I want to do a duet with you now.
But there you go. Somehow my mother thought that would be a good idea. Was it while I was in the Boy Scouts?
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Oh,
look at that child.
The Boy Scouts.
I know, right? It gets so much
What's
worse.
What's the badge
it?
For that?
You can sort of see why he moved to the other side of the world.
Hence
now,
why,
right?
I call my mother once a year.
Fellas, we're being told to wrap it up. We can't wait for this show. It is a week full of good stuff on 10, so be sure to tune in to the premiere of Would I Lie to You? Catch it tonight, 8:40 on 10 and 10 Play on demand. Frank and Chris, chookers.
Oh, we can't wait for it.
See you tonight.
Thanks for that. Cheers.